There has been a positive development in the pictures. I don't like to draw boring things. Something should be spinning, fall or fly. Nurlan Bajirov lives in a world where you see horses all around you. The artist presents its image with unimitable mastery in a wide variety of angles. They gallop facing to the galaxy in the cycle of the elements, in the frantic rhythm and in a magical leap. All this is extremely unusual and bright. This dynamism is adapted from life, where everything bubbles, explodes and freezes in a jump. It is the furious rhythm that allows us to be surprised at the thoughts of the artist, his philosophical world, where everything is subject to movement, where you cannot stop. Only looking forward, only in a rapid takeoff, you can find yourself and tell about yourself exactly as he did, Nurlan Bajirov, in his works. Everything is very simple. The artist was born a nomad, and his understanding of the nomadic culture of his ancestors was consciously, genetically entered into his consciousness and transmitted by graphic sheets of a mythical saga. All of it is from childhood. We were playing all equestrian games. If I draw cockpar, I know how to do it. How can a horse behave? What tricks you will expect? Only this way, you need to overcome everything. In childhood, I often saw when stallions were fighting. Here you see it, watch them, and this is what remains in memory. Therefore, it is easy for me to paint. If you dream, then it will be compositionally complex. Remember and implement within 3 to 4 days, at least to catch the movement, and then it will go on by itself. This is an internal struggle as in life. I go in for sports, and there is struggle, excitement.
Азарт.
Это сплетение фигур, сплетение тел, как говорил один из поэтов, создает вот такое эмоциональное напряжение у зрителя.
This is a plexus of figures, this plexus of bodies creates such an emotional tension in the audience that it simply explodes the brain. Exactly, the presentation is interesting. The attributes associated with our nomadic culture are very interesting too. There is our Жиль Казан. These are our 7 treasures. And among them, the main theme is the horse, the Тази, the dog. We can see them in his works. And of course, a well-trained golden eagle, a knife. But these are things without which a person who personifies himself as a nomad cannot cope with. Therefore, Nurlan Bajirov introduces them well into his compositions.
Человек, олицетворяющий себя номадом, поэтому их очень хорошо Нурлан Бажиров вводит в свои композиции.
The artist was born in Karagandy, in the family of miner. In the summer, he was sent to Karkaralinsk, where everything was filled with a special smell of freedom. The sky, grass, where the horizon is not visible. He roamed with shepherds. And this way of life of shepherds, nature, the world of animals, their character and behavior, awakened in him all the best feelings and a special love for horses. He spent hours watching their grace, the beauty of their plastic, listening to the sound that these animals made. These sounds also accompany his paintings. The neighing, the clatter, the cry of these animals will be with the artist when, for the first time, he dares to paint the experience that so excited him, and he will also hear the sounds of the steppe, the music of the nomad.
Это то, что наполняло жизнь кочевника, вся эта динамика, а с другой стороны...
This is what fills the life of a nomad, and on the other hand, such sacred contemplation, when the battle ended, when the long jump in the steppe ended. What should a nomad think? He thinks about the eternal, sitting on a horse in the steppe under the eternal sky.
Thank you. Первая работа это.
The first work on the Anrakai battle. Then I turned to the national theme, like Kazakh equestrian games. My style is difficult angles, as a passport. And in this picture, you see the battle of two dragons. Here the composition is complex, that sometimes I look and think how they did like this. It is complicated. Although, when I draw, I have all the visible lines. I draw them separately. I take pictures of all the stages and get the final result. If someone needs to look, I show all the stages, from sketch to original, step by step.
Рисую по отдельности, фотографирую стадии, а это уже конечный результат. Так что если кому-то нужно будет посмотреть, я могу показать все стадии. От эскиза и от форэскиза и уже по оригиналу.
Вот эта работа, которая как раз и является продолжением.
This work is just a continuation of the ancient animal style. And looking at these works, you begin to understand that the horseman culture has not gone anywhere. It is still in our blood. Its development, its continuation, a splash are shown in such works. Horseman culture continues to live on canvases of Nurlan Bajirov.
Продолжает жить на полотнах таких художников, как Нурлан Бажиров.
И, конечно, все это в такой космической, может быть, такой большой, ну, интересной очень композиции, ибо.
And of course, this is such an interesting cosmic composition. When Nurlan Bajirov creates his works, there is no boundaries for him. His horses do not ride on the ground; they look up the sky. They have no restrictions, neither from the right nor from the left. They are in some kind of space, I would say in a space that does not distract the viewer, but rather carries away with its dynamics, the crazy moment that it creates. It creates such an amazing tension, such an amazing drawing of details, which is difficult even to repeat.
Такое удивительное напряжение и такой удивительной прорисовки деталей, которых вообще трудно даже, ну, повторить.
Лошадь являлась естественной и весьма значимой частью культуры не только казахов, но и кочевников вообще. Скажем, с детских лет матери, бабушки обращались к детям не иначе, как к кулынам, жеребенок мой. И обряд, скажем, современный, то, что мы знаем как сундет-той, который воспринимаем как инициацию.
The horse is a natural and significant part of the culture, not only for Kazakhs, but also for the nomad in general. They say to children as kulunim, my foal, and the ride that we know as a sundet-той. In fact, in ancient times, it was the initiation of the rider. When the child turned to three, he sat on a horse and received gifts. And from that day, he became a member of this community of riders. Accordingly, many customs and rituals are associated with horses. Among all other rituals, the white horse was set free and was followed by an army.
Белый конь. Все-таки это не случайно, так как образ коня, в первую очередь, в сознании намадов связан был с солнцем. Солнце, как наш небесный отец, небесное око, дарующее жизнь, вечно бегущее по небосклону.
And was obliged to conquer all these lands through which the white horse passed. Nevertheless, this is not accidental, since the image of the horse in the minds of nomads was associated first of all with the sun, like our heavenly father, the heaven image of a nascent life, running across the horizon, was naturally associated with a horse. By the way, horses were domesticated on the territory of Kazakhstan, in northern Kazakhstan, in the settlement of Botai. Many evidence show that at that time the basic tools of some kind of handling a horse were developed. The Botais drank an ancient drink. That same horseman culture, that same equestrian military civilization was founded even then. The consequences of these were very significant for all of humanity, not only for our civilization. After riding a horse, set of opportunities that was most effective became possible. Nomads could defend their land, and for thousands of decades used to carry out large-scale conquests. The cult of the horseman as noble, exalted nobleman was created.
Культ всадника как благородного, возвышенного, знатного человека. Конь не только был уважаем, почитаем всячески.
The horse was highly respected. It was used in everyday life and in war. We can say that our entire civilization is a kind of monument to the horse, and our artists clearly continued this tradition. But Nurlan Bajirov clearly conveys the sensation that a person only felt when he sat astride a horse.
Четко передается то ощущение, которое человек впервые почувствовал, только усевшись верхом на коне.
Ибо лошадь в его произведениях – это не…
In his works, the horse is not a physiological creature. This is an image, first of all, and therefore it has own dynamics. I know very little draftsman like Nurlan Bajirov today. He said that he can draw a whole figure from one point. This is a talent.
Он сам говорил, что я могу от одной точки, допустим, нарисовать целиком фигуру. Это человек, ну, что говорит, это есть талант.
Getting into the world of Nurlan Bajirov, into the world of Kazakh Batyrs, the viewer immediately finds himself in a different dimension, in the world of energy, power and passion. From his paintings, we notice courage of the heroes of national epics, the theme of the national hero, the national favorite defender, prized in legends and tales, acquired a new vision in his work.
Мы говорили о сакральной стороне такого феномена, как лошадь в степи, да, ее духовная часть.
We are talking about the sacred side of such an image as a horse in the steppe, its spiritual part. Thus, the continuity of the ancient sacred veneration of the horse is traced, which most interesting is not only in ancient legends, but also in the works of modern masters. We see how the tulpar continues to soar in the sky, continuing this battle and giving us a sense of this desire to fly. The first riders experienced this desire.
И сообщая как бы нам ощущение вот этого стремления к полету, того же самого, что испытал первый всадник.
То, что в картинах есть хорошая энергия, это уже хорошо.
The fact that there is good energy in the paintings is already good. When you look at the picture and you feel immediately a surge of energy. When I draw such complex things, it happens that I felt the heat sometimes, I feel a smell. I draw horses. Then I feel the smell of a bridle, horse sweat. It all goes nearby, of course. If I tell about this, no one would believe me. But this is truth. I mostly paint myself. There I draw a mustache, a beard, eye turn. It is excitement, movement and work.
Там усы подрисовал бороду, глаз повернул, азарт движения. И работа.
His work interprets history in a special way, through the prism of traditions and the true realities. The world of the nomad, his visible and invisible connection with the horse, the symbol of his being, became for Nurlan Bajirov almost the main area of his art. Furious scenes of racing, competitions and battles are the main subjects of his works. With all the realism of the images of horses and riders, the viewer can guess something invisible and eternal that one can notice in ordinary life. Here I try not to cover those beautiful parts. The hind leg is beautifully bent. I already draw a rider, so that all parts of the horse body are visible. The golden color is like Сары Арка, yellow earth. Well, the Scythians had used this color.
Ну и у скифов тоже этот символ.
И вот сама подача, он очень грамотно.
And here the presentation is very good. Through these works, it shows the immutability of certain things, for the nomadic culture, our world. And again, speaking of the horse, horses in his works are not animals. These are indeed images. I think it will change. Artist has clear vision of the world, with his own presentation technology. an artist with an already established imaginative perception.
Сегодня художник со своим явным таким собственным видением мира, со своей собственной интересной, необычной очень технологией подачи, художник со своим уже сложившимся образным восприятием.
The more you look at the graphic sheets of Nurlan Bajirov, the more it becomes clear that the artist seemed interested and fascinated by the Japanese art school and was very impressed by the ancient scrolls depicting episodes of the struggle. Samurai aesthetics is read in Bajirov's series Samurai. The same fierce dynamism, the brightness of artistic decisions, the subtle elaboration of individual details. The horse head in the foreground is perfectly painted out. We see the rider in the throw, his movements. The skill of the artist amazes us.
Это из серии «Самурай». Вначале рисую скелет коня.
This is from the Samurai series. In the beginning, I draw a skeleton of the horse, then muscles. All these I draw. Then I draw the saddle, the full ammunition. Separately, I draw the man himself. Then I collect all these, and it turns out that the general composition is already obtained. In the beginning, I spray everything in gouache, so that I get the background, and then I paint with oil. In the end, with pencil and tinting. Well, and of course, if I draw a samurai, I study the history of the costume. Here, for example, when I drew a saddle and studied how they make saddles, the frame, this is the only saddle with ventilation. Here they have a hole, such as a summer air conditioner, so that it is not hot for them. And of course, in his large easel compositions, it is very difficult to insert into the graphics we are used to. These are large, huge compositions that can be compared with frescoes, which can be compared with large monumental compositions. And that presentation which I chose for myself is special stylization of paper for antique style. He specifically conveys such an ochre in various colors.
Настоящие мастера, большие мастера станковой графики, конечно, появились у нас в период 50-х, 60-х годов. Конечно, одним из самых, наверное, больших таких наших достижений это являлся даже Евгений Матвеевич Сидоркин. Человек, который приехал в Казахстан, вы знаете, в 57-м году и, в общем-то, погрузился в мир.
Real masters of easel graphics appeared here in 50s, 60s. Of course, one of our greatest achievements is Matvey Sidorkin, a man who came to Kazakhstan in 1957 and plunged into the world of Kazakh art, Kazakh life, Kazakh history. He is primordially Kazakhstan artist, a Kazakh artist. And I can't name right now any other one who would open the soul of the nomad in this way. Then the epic of the Kazakh people was published, then the fairy tales were drawn up. Evgeny Matveevich worked a lot and created a lot of great images. And among them, the famous Kazakh games, reading Saken Sifulin, a series devoted to motherhood. And all these works are stored in the Tretyakov Gallery. Today we can say that this is a world-class artist, and so it is. And of course, the young graphics artists of Kazakhstan are Makum Kisamidinov, Isata Isabayev, and many others who, for the first time, may have seriously begun to master such complex equipment as graphics, book graphics, easel graphics. And all these images created in those years today are some kind of a guideline which modern graphics need. Kazakhstan's graphics is peculiar that we historically do not have graphics. We can only work on the basis of some modern technologies that we developed by the Russian school where our children studied, European schools which are open now for us. And today it's a graphic that has much in common with some kind of graphic scenes, with some kind of graphic compositions.
Казахская графика, она своеобразна тем, что у нас истории графики нет. Мы можем только работать в настоящее время, опираясь на какие-то современные технологии, которые, в общем-то, были разработаны уже школами и российской школы, в которой учились наши ребята, европейскими школами, которые сейчас открылись для нас. И сегодня это больше, ну, графика которая перекликается во многом с изобразительными большими сценами, изобразительными большими какими-то композициями.
Bajirov uses modern graphics. Almost always the artist uses three color shades, so he focuses on the plot and events unfolding in the paintings. According to the experts, including foreign ones, the artist rides the genre of graphics to an unsurpassed level. His unique work was done in the innovative mix technique invented by the author. Thanks to it, on the canvases we see a magical effect on an image emerging through wet marble, in which everything is subject to a single plan, not a single extra detail. Even the golden ochre background of the paintings, which is beloved by the artist, carries a meaning. Either the steppe burned out under the scorching sun, or the flickering of Scythian gold. This is how Moscow art critics wrote about his style. People perceive like that. If you are standing nearby, people come and say, what a crazy dynamics. It happens usually like that. There is no cruelty. As many say, it is cruel work. There is no stiffness, dynamics and sport. When I draw sketches, then it's better to be alone. That's when the composition begins. I love to be alone.
Когда оказываешься среди работ Нурлана Бажирова,
when you find yourself among the works of Nurlan Bajirov, you are filled with some sort of sacred awe. Perhaps this is the very thing that the first Botai riders felt and the riders of the Great Steppe experienced. And even now they are experiencing the same feelings. Feelings of freedom, at the same time, and again the battle for this freedom. Battle in everything, between people and horses, between people and centaurs, and some kind of fantastic animals.
Между лошадьми и какими-то сказочными животными.
The artist has a whole world of opportunities for the realization of his plans and ideas, but always it is a whirlwind and wind, ranging passions and unrest. Nurlan Bajirov seems to be looking for opportunities to jump to where there are no borders. Being woven from the culture of nomadism, he tries to understand other meanings and other challenges. One day for that, he went to Spain. So I went to the bullfight to watch live. Before that, I painted, imagined how it could be. But when you feel this silence, when the bulls come out, when you draw the bulls, you also need to know how he will behave.
Когда рисуешь быков на коре, да, тоже нужно знать, как он себя поведет.
Видя все это, я думаю, художник, конечно, будет...
Seeing all this, the artist will be betrayed, of course. I think his art is not some kind of reflection, but his philosophy. This is the artist's attitude to the world around him, the transmission through his images of some messages, some premises, and their conclusions, which are necessary for modern man. Pictures of Nurlan Bajirov decorate the residences of presidents of Kazakhstan and Russia and are stored in private collections in Sweden, England, the United Arab Emirates and Russia. We're presented at exhibitions around the world. Of course, the topic that the author follows is not always understood and accepted by the viewer. But of course, those who could see in this melody of graphic canvases the mesmerizing echo of author's spiritual quest, his amazing thirst for life, his passion and burning love for the world will forever remember these realities created by the unsurpassed artist, so brave and so widely talented. Would you like to go for a moment to the world where horses gallop in the unimaginable beauty, touching with their manes, feathers? Give it a try, and they will carry you to where only heaven is higher.